When creating a set of construction drawings, there are many parts of the building you will need to add detailed information to. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add an insertion point to a CAD detail and how to use the insertion point. You can draw CAD details in the CAD Detail pages, which you can create by going to the CAD drop-down menu here at the top of your screen, go to CAD Detail Management, and here you can see the CAD detail pages I've already created. You can create new pages, rename, copy, or delete the existing details. You can also access them here in your project browser. You can create new CAD details by right-clicking on this folder and then clicking on New CAD Detail. Here you can name your CAD detail pages anything you want. I'll call this one Deck Details for future use. Now I'll close that CAD detail. When you close a CAD detail, it will automatically save. There is no save button for the detail. As you can see here, I have drawn a couple of details, one for the foundation and floor framing, and one for the roof eave. I'll double-click here on the foundation's floor framing detail to open it up. CAD details are two-dimensional drawings created with CAD tools like lines, polylines, circles, text, arrows, and dimensions. These are drawn to scale so that when you add dimensions, they will read correctly. In my floor plan view, you can see that I have already created a back-clipped cross-section camera. I'll double-click on the camera callout here to open the cross-section view. Here I want to add some detail to this cross-section view. First, I'll go to the foundation floor framing detail that I've already drawn. I want to block all of this information together so that it will move and behave as one object. I'll select everything by clicking and dragging a selection box with my cursor. Then here in the Edit toolbar at the bottom of my screen, you'll find the Make CAD Block tool. When I click on it, it will essentially glue everything together as a CAD block. Now I may want to use this for future projects, so I want to add it to my library browser. Again, here in the Edit toolbar at the bottom, I'll click on the Add to Library tool. When I do, you can see it added here in the library browser in my user catalog. When I click on this in the library browser, it will open the editor so that I can rename it. I'll rename this Foundation Floor Framing Detail. Now as you can see, with it selected, I can place it into my drawing. I'll delete that and then go into my cross-section elevation. I want to place this detail here on the floor line of this building. However, you can see that it's difficult to get it in the exact position that I need it. So I'll make a change to that detail. I'll go back into my CAD detail page, select this block, and then explode the CAD block. Now, each component is separate again. When I blocked everything together, it placed an insertion point at the center of all the objects, but I want to be able to insert it at a specific point. So, I'll go here to the Points tool in the toolbar at the top and place a point here at the upper left corner of my stem wall. Points are not CAD objects that you can select, move, or delete. They are temporary reference points. To delete them, go again to the Points tool and click on the Delete Temporary Points tool. This will delete all temporary points in this view. I'll place that point again here on the corner of my stem wall. It will snap right to the end of the lines. Then select everything in the detail and click on Make CAD Detail tool to block them together. Then before I release the block, here in the Edit toolbar, I will click on Select Insertion Point. And as you can see, it will locate the point as indicated by the red circle around it. Click on it. Now you can see that the Move Edit handle has been placed exactly on that point. Now again, I will add this to my library browser. Then I'll delete the first one that I have in here. And I will rename this one Foundation Floor Framing Detail. I'll go back to my cross section, click on the detail in the library browser, zoom in close to the top of the stem wall, and click to place the detail on top of this section view. Now let's do it one more time for the roof eave detail. Open up the detail I've already drawn in here. Go to the Points tool and place a point right here at the upper left-hand corner of the wall's top plate. Select everything in the detail and block it together. Then click on Select Insertion Point and click on the temporary point. Now click on Add to Library and rename it. Then I'll go back to my cross section, click on the detail to select it out of the library, then zoom in close to where the wall's top plate will be, and click to place the detail block. Now my section has all the necessary building detail information.